carried out. So after undercutting operation, we have to check this dimension. It must be a 25 mm. See here, you can see the total length of the unmachined surface is 25 mm. So same way, we have to check the width is also. This must be a 10 mm. See, this is the 10 mm. In the same way, the diameter also have to check. See, in the same way, you have to check the diameter. So this is exactly 19 mm required. Now it is still minus around 0.5. The tolerance is less or minus 0.5. Then it is okay. So after completion of this undercutting portion, so you have to check the dimension of this here to here this 25 mm, here to here 10 mm, this diameter is 19, plus or minus 0.5. okay. So after completion of the undercutting, we have to perform the taper turning operations. You have to form the angular surface of the workpiece. For this, we have to calculate the angle. So this calculation of angle is already explained in the previous video. So as per the calculation, we are using the compound slide swivel method for taper turning. For this purpose, the compound slide has to swivel to the required angle. So for that, there is a two locking bolts on the compound slide. So you have to loosen this. One is front side and another one is back side. So you have to loosen this bolts by using 15 spanner. Compound slide . See here, there is a graduations marking are there. So now it exactly is, the compound is straight to the parallel to the axis of the lathe. Now we have to swivel the compound slide to the angle of 5 degrees 42 minutes. So this is, you can see here the marking is both the side, left side and right side. For that, we have to take the reference which side is the smaller diameter. Now if you hold the workpiece like this, the right side is the smaller diameter and left side is the bigger diameter. Hence, we have to swivel the compound slide towards the right side because the smaller diameter is in the right side. So we have to take the graduation reading here. See, this is 0, this is 5 degrees 42 minutes. See here, so very near to 6 degrees. So position the compound slide and lock the bolts previously. After swiveling the compounds to the right side to the calculated angle of 5 degrees 42 minutes, then turn the turning tool to the position. So while taper turning, the tool must be a angular to the axis of the workpiece. The point must be in a front side, such a way that you have to lock the tool. For this operation, again we have to select the speed. That must be a 500. For 500 speed, the gear lever position is in A and now the speed is 500. Select for this tool, the speed is 500. After that, we switch on the machine and position the tool to the turning point. For this operation, you have to remove the tie stock away from the center. Otherwise, the tie stock is touching with the compound slide. Hence, you take it away the tie stock. Then position the tool with the carriage. After bringing the tool to the position, you have to move the tool by using the compound slide, not by the carriage. So now, give the depth of cut and move the compound slide like this. Again, take it back, give the depth of cut and move the tool. Like this, you have to perform the angular form on the workpiece. See, you can see the tool is moving angular to the axis of the rotation, reforming the
taper on the workpiece. This operation is to be carried out up to the removal of this diameter touching with this 19 diameter by repeating the same process. Now I am going to give the final cut. The diameter has been exactly coincided with this 19 diameter. You can see at the right here in the cut. So then slowly move the tool to get the good surface finish. We can remove the burr in the last end by feeding the plunging the tool inside the workpiece slightly. So now the complete operation has been finished. So now we can see the workpiece has been prepared as per your drawing. See here. So the facing has been carried out, center drilling, chamfering, plane turning, and also taper turning, undercutting. So this is the final object what we are going to finish after completing different operations.